For many problems, they are so complex that it will take trillions of years to solve them on regular computers. Those are the problems that quantum computers are particularly powerful for. Hi, I'm Andrew Houck. I'm a quantum physicist at Princeton. Quantum physics is the science of the world of the microscopic and atomic scale, where the rules and the intuition that you've built up from your day-to-day life don't hold anymore, and very bizarre things can happen. For example, the principle of superposition is of fundamental importance. Superposition says that an object can be in more than one state at the same time. Most famously, Schrödinger talked about superposition when he talked about Schrödinger's cat, a cat that in principle could be both alive and dead at the same time. That intuitively doesn't make sense. We don't see cats walking around that are both alive and dead, but at a quantum level, objects can be in two mutually exclusive states at the same time. One of the things that excites me about the principles of quantum physics is that we can turn around and use them to build fundamentally new devices, like a new kind of computer called a quantum computer. Quantum computers solve problems in fundamentally different ways from regular computers. Rather than solving each step of a problem a little bit faster, quantum computers can solve certain problems in fundamentally fewer steps. You can choose a number between 1 and 4, and you can ask your computer to try and guess the number. If we played this game on a classical computer, you would get it wrong maybe on your first guess, you maybe get it wrong on your second guess. Even if you got the number wrong on your third guess, you would still know the answer, because it's just the fourth number. On a quantum computer, the device will know the number every single time after a single guess. It sounds impossible, but we've done this in the lab. Quantum physics describes the atomic world, but in order to build a computer, in order to build a device, things get bigger and more complicated, and noise tends to introduce errors. When I talk about noise, I'm not talking about sound, I'm talking about microscopic noise, electrons moving around uncontrollably, a little bit of magnetic field that comes because somebody on the other side of the building took an elevator. We are trying to preserve these incredibly weak signals and isolate them from the world in order for this quantum nature to be preserved. But at the same time, if we have a computer that's completely isolated from the world, we can't actually program it, we can't use it. We need to simultaneously keep something almost completely isolated and have very fast access for the exact person you want to use it. And solving these challenges is a multidisciplinary challenge of the highest order. It requires understanding the algorithms you're trying to run on the quantum computer, the systems architecture, how you can build all of these qubits together and control them. And it involves picking absolutely perfect materials and understanding these deep materials challenges. Some of the problems that are most clearly going to be benefited by quantum computers are problems that at their core involve quantum physics. When we try and think about how a molecule works, a molecule consists of a bunch of atoms, and those are quantum mechanical objects. Our computers are classical objects, and so it takes a huge computer in order to simulate even a very simple molecule. This could open the door to things like using quantum computers for drug discovery or materials development. Quantum computers also seem to have a lot of promise for problems in machine learning. And you can imagine combining the biggest technology revolutions in computing of quantum computing and machine learning and see where that will take you. My name is Andrew Houck, and I'm a forward thinker.